I'm not per se against adoption or per se against inter-country adoption. I'm just against the way it is done.
Arun Dole, German, born to Indian parents, adopted in 1973 from Pune.
They think they are adopting orphans and not children which have been taken from the parents.
33 years later, he is angry, trying to make sense of it all.
Once you realize you're nothing else than a chicken, yeah, which can be moved like this, like a commodity, I mean, it's just bad, isn't it?
33 years ago, Arun Dole's adoptive parents walked into Mahila Sevagram Ashram, adopted him and returned to Germany. India then did not have an adoption law. But when we walked into Preet Mandir, $12,000 was what it would take to subvert all the adoption laws enacted since then.
A few months into the investigation and we noticed a curious pattern. Preet Mandir was regularly turning away Indian parents for no reason at all.
For the Khonas, parents of two adopted children, Preet Mandir is a trauma they would rather forget.
So he said, "Wo ladka to kisi aur ko de diya, Jalandhar wale ko de diya, aisa waisa." Accidentally, some foreigners were taking it. She saw.
Us din pura din roi thi main. कुछ बोलने जैसा ही नहीं था, किसी के साथ बात भी नहीं किया मैंने.
He had a list. ये महीने में इतने आएंगे, ये महीने में इतने आएंगे. ठीक है, आपको इसमें पसंद नहीं आता, आप इस महीने के बाद आओ. इतने लड़के होंगे, इतनी लड़कियां होंगी. He had a list.
All this despite the fact that adoption agencies in India are bound by law to promote adoptions within the country.
That 50% of Indian adoption is mandatory.
But government records reveal that compared to the 50% norm, Preet Mandir sends 60% of the children in their care outside India. Clearly, Preet Mandir always has the cradle full for foreign parents.
I needed somebody to say, "We can give you a baby anyway." And the man that I spoke to was saying, "Well, what would you like, a boy or a girl?" And I said, "Well, I just want a baby." He goes, "But madam, we have either. Which do you want?" And I was like, and I was very surprised to hear that it was that easy, that I literally just had to ring up with my specifications.
Our investigations revealed a clever manipulation. Preet Mandir was regularly forging documents for some of the children to show that they were not finding families in India.
These non-acceptance letters are bogus. But why they are doing it? Because the law requires 3 non-acceptance letters. And some of these placement agencies have a tie-up. They have a tie-up with adoption agencies abroad that, okay, I will send you X amount of money every year to support your various programs. You will give so many number of children every year to our families.
This is the proof. Children House International, an American adoption agency, proudly announces complete sponsorship of Mata Vaishno Devi Trust, an adoption agency in Pune. Such sponsorships are completely illegal.
I'm just so shocked. I feel it needs to be stopped. It needs to be exposed. People have to know the other face of adoption.
Some adoption agencies have learnt the fine art of breaking the law and still being on its right side. Like Preet Mandir. 6 years ago, its license was revoked. But J.S. Bhasin's cloud ensured that he was back in business soon. Free to run India's biggest baby shop. In Pune, with Anjita Roy Chowdhury, V.K. Shashi Kumar.